Now to rebuilding an entire community near Hamburg, Iowa.
The city itself spared, but parts of the countryside are still in crisis.
KTV News Watch 7's Ryan Luby live with a story you'll see only on 7, Ryan.
And Rob, we're talking about extreme southwest Iowa and extreme northwest Missouri, specifically near the levee breach itself, which is right about here. The people who live in this area are finally getting to see what's left of that levee up close, and so are you.
Just keep her cut and come straight back.
Fight a flood and fight your way around it, and good luck. But find someone like Ed Forrell. He and his friend Denny.
A 500-horse Cadillac.
And both men already have. Both farmers in extreme northwest Missouri don't have any other choice.
Only way.
No other way to take you and the world on a big picture, full throttle tour of trouble.
This is unbelievable.
Yeah. Bad. It's real bad.
Trouble that's torn away, in some cases, the evidence.
The foundation right there, that was the whole house is gone.
Someone's home, someone's livelihood, and that's just the start.
You want to go around here to the south?
Yeah, we got to.
The start. If there are two people who can prove how pervasive of a problem there is and was, Denny and Ed can.
It's just total devastation.
Water left a mark of misery several feet high just about everywhere, to farms, to homes, and then there's Ed's home. You can count his among those that need help.
Man.
Once a farmhouse, now it's a lake house instead.
I don't like it.
Nothing to like from that porch, nothing to like below it.
Crawdads in the sandstone, it's your lucky day, buddy. Gonna turn you loose.
Ask Ed, this nuisance, this nightmare, comes from the problem he and Denny want you to see. Both want to show you that levee, up close, impersonal, like no one's seen since June. That breach that's to blame, then the channel or chute reopened by the Corps 7 years ago.
All this current from this channel was forced right at this levee right here, and that's what blew the levee out. There's no doubt about it.
Doubt or not, there's still devastation to the levee.
It's gotten bigger since it blew originally, probably doubled in size or more.
Devastation, too, that's left families fighting a flood that hasn't gone away. A fight that's been tough to traverse.
Now, despite the concerns about that chute or channel, the Corps of Engineers tells me it didn't have any negative impact on that levee. They say that chute or channel was designed appropriately. Still, just to be sure, it is something the Corps might reassess.